Well, before I got a house, first I got myself a spouse, and the spouse turned my house into a home that is so heavenly.
A house is not a home without love. You couldn't grow a lot without the seed.
So before I grew a lawn, first I got a guy with brawn, and the brawn carried on, grew my lawn, and fulfilled all my needs.
You can't brew coffee
without a pot,
or hit the jackpot
without the slot.
You can't bake biscuits
without a pan.
Make love, love, love
without a man.
A house is not a home without love. A hen can't lay an egg without a nest.
So I got myself a nest and a rooster who's the best, and my nest has been blessed from above. Now me and my fowl,
now she and her fowl,
hysterically howl,
hysterically howl.
Warbling party is a great success. We only invited our most intimate friends, and all 800 of them showed up. And here comes my favorite columnist.
Hello, Jayne Mansfield. Hello to you from Hollywood. You look simply ravishing.
Thank you, Luella, and welcome to my house of love. Luella, how do you like my house of love?
Exquisite, Jayne. Simply exquisite. I especially love the color scheme.
I'm glad you noticed it. Nikki and I created a brand new color for our house. It's called Passion Pink.
Passion Pink. There's no end to your talent. This house of love is so different, so unusual. How did you go about planning it? I want an exclusive.
Light the incense.
Light the incense.
Spray the perfume.
Spray the perfume.
Let romance prevail.
Let romance prevail.
In every room.
In every room.
You know, when I decided to decorate my house, I thought about the colors I should choose. Gold is impressive. Purple's expressive, especially when trimmed with chartreuse. As for periods, Louis Couture's bores me. Chippendale ain't hip. I also think that Sheraton is dowdy, Renaissance is rowdy, and modernistic is old-fashioned, like ranch mink. So, after thinking it over for a while, I decided to create my own style. It's Mansfield. Passion. Pink. The lounge is lazy. The carpet's crazy. I dig the chandelier. The lights are spooky. The love seat's kooky. I think I'm gonna like it here. The house I live in is not for prudes. The spirit's young and it's hung with nudes. 1,000 paintings I watch, you'll see. Upon each wall and they're all of me. The beds are bouncy, the pillows flouncy. The boudoir is sincere. the spring's a springy, ring-a-dingy. I think you're gonna like it. Here, Barker Brothers, J.W. Sloan, ooh, I'll make it on my own. The den is frantic and so romantic, with cushions front and rear. And when you enter, I'm in the center. I think you're gonna like it. Here, my patio is a sexy spot. The statuary is very hot. My swimming pool is a sizzling sea. It's velvet draped and it's shaped like me. The kitchen's campy, the decor's vampy, the color scheme is queer. There is no frigidaire or oven for who needs food when you live on lavish. I think I'm gonna like it.
She thinks she's gonna like it.
Miss Mansfield, me Bette, you Jane. That's an old tarsen joke.
Miss Davis, I'm so glad you could come to our party.
Thank you. It is charming, really charming. I wonder if you invited Philip Harris, Philip Dawn, or Philip Crosby.
Are they all friends of yours?
No, I just love to say, Philip, may I have a cigarette?
Philip Morris?
No, Winston.
Oh, you're right, Betty. It's what's up front that counts.
You should know, darling.
Betty, have you toured through our house of love?
Yes, and it's positively perfectly precious. Everything's so luxurious and expensive-looking.
Well, I don't ask for much out of life. Just a few simple necessities.
Good. Tell me more, darling. Tell me more. Here, Lolly Parsons, you sit beside me and we'll listen to Jay.
President said, and I agree, that we must balance our economy. There are problems that we all must face, and luxuries are out of place. JFK, you're right. I'm joining in the fight. I don't want expensive treasures. I prefer the simple pleasures, like a Longfellow poem, a Cadillac brougham, a villa in Rome or in Spain. I'm just plain Jane.
Oh, Jane, you just do marvelous.
I've no eyes for modern chic things. I adore those cheap antique things. A Van Dyke I'll take, a Rembrandt is Jake, and I'll make a capital gain. I'm just plain Jane.
Why didn't you let Jimmy McHugh do your arrangements, dear?
Money isn't everything. I don't want a billion. A little loot will suit me fine. A modest little million. I don't need a mink to warm me. Other furs do much more for me. An ermine dyed blue, a chinchilla too, a sable will do for the rain. I'm just plain Jane.
Oh, Janie, I think it's just too wonderful for you to be so patriotic and give up so many luxuries for the sake of our economy. In the words of William Randolph Hearst, America first, after yourself. Now tell me more about your sacrifices.
I don't care for gaudy playthings. Give me common everyday things. Like the Taj Mahal lot, a platinum yacht. I've already got a gold plane. I'm just plain Jane.
I'm telling all of Hollywood.
I'm not rich, I have a few chips. All my stocks are strictly blue chips. Like AT&T and General E. I bought me the A&B chain. I'm just plain Jane.
This is an exclusive.
Real estate is not my line. I don't want a palace. Oh, I own 50 acres, but they're all in downtown Dallas. Now you have the inside story, the entire inventory of all of my stocks, my real estate blocks. I wash all my socks in champagne. My kids play catch with diamond rocks, and I hold the mortgage on Fort Knox. In gold I trust, because I'm just plain, plain Jane.
Oh, Janie, I'm simply exhausted.
Mickey, look what's rolling toward us, Charles Laughton.
Good evening, Miss Mansfield. Good evening, Michael. Quite an establishment you've got here.
Thank you. You're very sweet. What are you staring at?
I remember someone once said good things come in small packages. He didn't know you, Jayne Mansfield.
I try to stay healthy. I exercise. I'm in good shape.
Don't tell me. Just let me look.
Well, if you don't want to exercise, you can keep in condition by getting lots of love.
Is that what keeps you slim?
Oh, yes. The more I love, the slimmer I get.
Tell me your secret, Jayne. Tell me truthfully. How do you manage to look so good?
They say that food's a substitute for love. We eat too much. It really is a sin. So if you're gaining weight, Charles, it's not too late. I'll let you in on how I'm keeping thin. Plenty of love and 20 calories keeps me trim and brings me untold bliss. Breakfast time, here's what I take. Half a prune and one cornflake. And for dessert, a 30-minute kiss. Plenty of love and 20 calories. You grow fat each time you feed your face. Lunchtime, I eat all I need. Two peeled grapes and a poly seed. For dessert, a passionate embrace. At 3 p.m., my hunger grows. To eat, I get the yen. Instead of bread, and goodness knows, I fall in love again. Plenty of love and 20 calories. Hunger makes you younger, Freud agrees. Dinner, I don't eat at all. I cut out a food and I have a ball. Waiter, just bring water if you please. Plenty of love and 20 calories. If you'll kindly pay attention, I will take the time to mention the calorific score of the foods we all adore. Now a slice of bread is 90 and 50 more. But a nice long kiss will bring you bliss, and it only counts for four. evening, a glass of beer's 200. It's a very fattening brew. But a crazy grab will reduce the flab, and the count is minus 2. Even no cow's 250, and it's tasteless as can be. Instead of no cow, just bite your gal. If you got no gal, bite me. Each time I have a love affair, I lose weight front and rear. If I turn sideways now, I swear, you'd see me disappear. Wow, plenty of love and 20 calories. Try it, is the diet that agrees. Weekends, you'll get such a treat. You'll love so much, you'll forget to eat. Love's the purest protein, try it please. Plenty of love, with plenty of love. Oh, plenty of love and 20 calories. Oh, isn't it a wonderful party, Mickey? More famous feet have sunk in our carpet in one night than Grauman's Chinese theater cemented in 30 years. Directors, producers, actors, even people.
Yes, Janie. By the way, we must greet Noel Coward.
Good evening, Jane, darling. I told you, I'll see you again. Good evening, Michael.
You can call him Mickey, Noel.
Thank you. And you, my dear, may call me Mr. Coward.
Oh, you're so, so precious.
Miss Mansfield, if I may say so, and I may, I've never seen you looking more ravishing, alluring, tempting, and sensual than you do tonight.
Oh, thank you, Noel. Do you really think I look sexy?
Do you look sexy? My dear girl, you could turn the statue of a marble saint into a raving maniac.
You're pulling my leg.
And a pretty one it is. Women somehow remind me of roast beef.
Roast beef? What a strange comparison.
At 20, rare. At 30, choice. At 40, prime. And at 50, cold cuts.
No, I just love to hear you talk. You're so brilliant.
You see how easy it is to be truthful. I would have been here earlier, but I had 3 appointments. Joe E. Lewis invited me to high tea. I had cocktails with Shirley Temple and told her an old fairy tale. And then I had to run over to 20th Century Fox and give Elvis Presley a diction lesson. Amazing boy, that Elvis. He'd rather writhe than be president.
Noel, how do you like my house of love?
Enchanting. You do have lovely artwork here. By the way, Jane, have you a library?
Of course I have a library. And it's filled with the works of Ibsen, Shakespeare, Proust, Aristotle, Mencken. To me, literature is much more important than sex.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a recording.
Sincere. I'm a vulture for culture.
Janie?
Yes, Mickey?
It's that time.
Oh, excuse me, Noel. Every night at this hour, Mickey and I have a rendezvous. Would you care to join us?
Egad! Private lives again. I know 3 is a crowd, but tonight, Jane, I feel so gregarious.
In our boudoir. How do you like it?
It's all very confusing. I see you've got twin beds separated by a 5-foot shelf. I know Mickey's very athletic, but isn't that a little hard to hurdle? Why don't you and Mickey tell me more about your cultural capers?
The stories in the public press that deal with life at this address, do not reflect our point of view.
In fact, they're often far from true.
The public image we have built, we play in public to the hilt.
But here I let my muscles rust.
And I can cover up my bust. We're cultural, not sexual. Intrigued with the intellectual. Here we sit, engrossed in literature, ignoring the allure of anything less pure. In our bedroom, classic art is all
Shakespeare, wall to wall.
We're cultural, not physical. So keen to learn, so quizzical. I would rather go to bed with Proust.
You must have deduced she can't be seduced.
No, we think love should be a proper noun.
Sex tears the body down.
What disgrace. All this talk of passion plus
patent plays is quite enough of sex for us.
You're telling me, Mickey, too much. We're cultural, not sexual. Sex makes one ineffectual. With each affair, they say a brain cell dies, and so libido-wise, we economize. And all through life, we'll sit and read in bed, then leave our brains to Harvard men. We have read Greek mythology, Oedipus Rex, the Kinsey Report, and the history of sex. And a gay Russian novel, what wit and what charm. It's called Lolita of Sunnybrook Farm.
Tell me, darling, how do you feel about Ibsen?
Oh, I adore Ibsen while tippling a Gibson.
Speaking of tippling, how about Kipling?
Oh, well, I don't really know. I've never kippled. We're studious, not passionate. And as for sex, we ration it. Love's a bore, and strictly entre nous. We sometimes score, it's true, but only our IQ. My IQ is easy to recall. It's just the size of my bust.
Think of that.
We're cultural. We read a lot. And as for love, don't need a lot. Sigmund Freud says love is an abuse, and its only use is to reproduce. So we're happy, life is never hard.
Sharing a library card.
He's my guy, intellectually inclined.
I'd never try putting mattress over mine.
Oh, Mickey, certainly not. Who would? We're cultural, not sexual. And if this thought affects you all, if a myth our frankness has destroyed, sex we'll still avoid, and so it's back to Freud. Well, that's enough of culture for tonight. Darling, turn out the light. Oh, Mickey, our housewarming is a big success. Everybody in Hollywood turned out for the party. There's Tallulah Bankhead. Hello, Tallulah.
Darling, I just had to tell you how much I love your House of Love. If there's one thing I love to talk about, it's love. Flex your biceps again, Mickey. Egad, why couldn't they have slipped me a Mickey like that?
Well, I can't understand why you don't have a man like my Mickey. You're all woman.
Sweetie, you're looking at yourself in the mirror. That's me over there.
Oh.
That's what I mean. I can't understand it.
I've written books on love. I've written songs on love. I've written poems on love. But let's talk about you, Jane, darling.
Oh, no, I'd rather talk about you. Tallulah, you're my idol. You're as great as one can be.
And, darling, you have merited the charms you've inherited from me. I had what you've got when I had it.
I'm glad that I've got what you had, but something has been added.
Not bad. I did what you do when I did it.
I'm glad that I do what you did.
You show it, but I hid it.
How sad. One thing sure, you must have a lure.
Oh, the public stays away.
The fans all lunge when the necklines plunge.
So we're out to lunge each day. I show what you show when I showed it.
I'm glad that I show what you showed.
You show what you show because you're loaded.
I'm glad I have what you had and do what you did.
You're not doing bad, so keep it up, kid. So show it,
make him know it
all the time.
My house of love is wonderful, isn't it?
It's the living end. The only thing that can top it is World War III. And that will be the living end. Tell me honestly, are people still making love?
Of course, Tallulah. Everybody's making love all over the world.
They are. I must be following the giants too closely. Then why? Do tell me about it, darling.
Birds do it, bees do it, Chinese and the Japanese do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. And now and then, normal men do it. Diplomats at the UN do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. Know the square and the bop it, do it. It's as simple as that. Why, Luella, Miss O'Hara, Hopper, do it. But she still wore her hat. The swinging cats do it. Chicks do it. Chorus girls who like to mix do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Llamas and lynx do it. Marmosets and even minks do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Utes do it. Sioux do it. Eskimos in their igloos do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Both Khrushchev and Adenauer do it. And it drove Castro nuts. Why? Winchell saw Eisenhower do it. Doing golf between putts. The silent sphinx in Egypt do it. Even mummies in their crypt do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Knobs do it, swells do it, everyone in these hotels do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. The waitress says, if you please do it. Captains and the maitre d's do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. A mountain goat and a kettle do it. It's just nature, I guess. Why, I saw Major Riddle do it. The but with minor success. The amateurs and the vets do it. Even gamblers laying bets do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. You music men, I suppose, do it. Violinists with their bows do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. I know the horns and the flutes do it. Trumpet players using mutes do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. I saw the bass, who's real gone, do it. And the drummer, I vow, Bill Reddy, and his baton, do it. And he's ready right now. The symphonies and the bands do it. Pianists without their hands do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
Very much. God bless you all. Have a ball and good night. Would you like to have this? Hello, how wonderful. Tell me, dearest, if you had it to do all over again, well, would you do it all over again?
Well, as long as my strength held out.